Hello there, beautiful people, ladies and gentlemen. My name is Miss Danielle. Here on my channel, we talk about all things Jesus Christ. We got Bible studies, biblical teaching, prayer, words of encouragement. If that's something you're interested in, make sure you hit the subscribe button and let's get right into the video. Today, my beautiful people, today we're going to be talking about the characteristics of biblical love. And this comes from 1 Corinthians 13:4. The reason that it is important to understand biblical love is because this is the successful version of love. There have been so many new teachings about love and relationships, but I want to remind you that God himself created love and Jesus Christ himself was love. So this is the type of love that you need to be following in everyday relationship, in your marriage, and everything like that. These are characteristics of what love is. A lot of us, we are in relationships with people where it's not real love, you feel me? This is real love, and I'm about to tell you why. So the first characteristic of biblical love that comes from the book of 1 Corinthians in the chapter 13 verse 4 is love is patient. Now let me remind you, patient is the word you want to focus in on. Love is patient. Patient means that love, like this biblical love, can take time. It can take time to grow and get to know a person and just to be all the way fully in sync with this person, whether it's our spouse or our children or whatever. It takes time. Also, when it's patient, this requires growth. You might have to grow through this type of love. And this type of love that is patient, this biblical type of love, it waits. So if you are dealing with a person that doesn't want to wait for you, whether it's sexually or just growth wise in general, they don't have real love for you. Real love waits. And also the last thing is it bears. When love is patient, it bears things. It can take on things. It's strong. It can withstand the tests of time. So if you was in a relationship that didn't withstand the tests of time, it may not have been real love. The second biblical characteristic of love is kind. So when something is kind, let me remind you, it's gentle. Whether this be the way a person is speaking to us, the way a person is handling us, the way a person is acting in general, this person is gentle, it's kind, it's soft, you know what I mean? Like, it's comforting, it's kind. Also, when something is gentle, it's thoughtful. So this type of love that is kind, it thinks about how we feel. They put themselves in our shoes, you know what I'm saying? It's not all about them. And this is the type of love you want to be looking for. Also, the third characteristic of biblical love is love never gives up. So my thing is, when something never gives up, it never fails, because once you give up, that's when you fail. So if someone gave up on you, or they just threw you away or abandoned you, they may not have really loved you. And when I tell you this, these characteristics are what real love is, because this is straight from God's word. This is what he put in force. So if somebody gave up on you, it wasn't real love. If you gave up on somebody else, it may not have been real love, and that's okay. But when you start to get into a new relationship, the relationship God has called you to be in, you don't want to give up on it. You want to keep going, keep trying, and just keep pushing through and stick with this person and love them through everything. The fourth biblical characteristic of love is love keeps faith and is always hopeful. So when something keeps faith, it's confident. This type of love is confident in you. They trust you. They're not insecure. They're not projecting insecurity on you. They trust you. You know what I mean? Also, when something has faith and hopeful, it's positive and optimistic. So when something is hopeful, they have the best. They think highly of you. You know, they you're honorable in their eyes. You're not the scum of the earth in their eyes. Like, they really believe in you. When something has faith, it believes in the relationship, the situation, or whatever. You know what I'm saying? Real love keeps faith. Also, the fifth characteristic of biblical love is it endures through every circumstance. So when something endures through every circumstance, it bears all things. I mean, it's going to make it through. So you may be going through a rough patch in your marriage or your relationship, but just know if the love is real, you're going to get through it. You feel me? And when something endures, it's going to make it through. Like, you might get hit. You might get shot a couple times. You feel me? But you're going to make it through. You're going to pull through. You're going to push through. So keep that in mind when you are loving someone, or when you're dealing with someone that claims they love you. Make sure they can do this. You feel me? And if you want to sign up for getting married, being a wife or a husband, remember that God wants you to endure through it. He wants you to get through it. He wants it to be lifelong, and he wants it to make it through the tests of time. The sixth biblical characteristic of love is love is not self-seeking. So look, this type of biblical love is not selfish. It compromises. When something isn't self-seeking, they compromise. They can be like, okay, we can come together on that. We can do it like that. We both can do it. You know, I can let go of how I'm thinking or how I'm feeling, and we can do it that way. They compromise. Also, this, when it's not self-seeking, it's generous. So it's helpful. This type of person, when they're loving you, they're helping you. They're being there for you. They're taking away how they feel and they helping you. And vice versa. You taking away how you feel and you helping them. It's not self-seeking. So if you with somebody that's selfish and it's always all about them and they don't care how you feel, it's their way or the highway. Or if you're like that, it's your way or the highway. That's not real love. And you need to really examine the situation or examine yourself. Also, the seventh biblical characteristic of love is not easily angered. When something is not easily angered, it isn't irritable. It's not quick to pop off. It's not quick to cuss you out or, you know, like slander you or nothing like that. Also, it's not quick temper. Again, this type of person, when you come to them, they may be frustrated or they might be irritated. But if they really are exemplifying and exuding the example of love that Christ has gave us, it's not going to be quick temper. You can come to them, they're patient with you, they're kind, they're gentle, they're generous, and vice versa. If you're the lover, you're kind, you're patient, you're gentle, you're not easily angered. And this can come into effect in a lot of our different relationships, not just marriage, like with our children. Sometimes children can be a lot to handle, you're stressed out. And if you really love them and you want to love them like Christ loves, you're going to be patient with them. You're not going to be always on edge and on 10 with them. The eighth biblical characteristic of love is love doesn't keep a record of wrongs. So if something doesn't keep a record of wrongs, it's forgiving. The Bible reminds us to forgive 70 times 7. And it also reminds us if we don't forgive others, God is not going to forgive us. So stop holding those grudges. Also, if something doesn't hold a record of wrongs, it's not resentful. If your spouse or partner has hurt you, don't resent them. You know what I'm saying? Let it go. Forgive them fully. And the best way to do this is to pray about it. Ask God, say, Lord, come into my heart and give me the strength to forgive this person who has wronged me and that really hurt me. And just work on it every day. That's forgiveness is something you have to work at every day. And it's a whole process to forgiveness. But it's definitely in your best interest. And in the long run, it will pay off. Forgiving those who've hurt you or wronged you, whether it's family members, friends, relationships, whatever. Also, if something doesn't hold a record of wrongs, it doesn't hold grudges. So stop holding them grudges to them people that hurt you when you was a kid, or to your man or your woman that has hurt you or wronged you. Forget it. Let it go. You feel me? Forgive 70 times 7. We as people, we are sinful. We are in our flesh. We are not perfect, and you ain't either. So it's important that we don't hold a record of wrongs against people. Forget it. Forgive and forget. Let it go. Move on. Every day is a new day. And, you know, God does the same thing with us. He's not holding stuff that we did against us from our past. He's let it go. He's forgiven us. He showed us grace and he had mercy on us. So you should do the same thing with other people. Also, the ninth characteristic of biblical love is love protects, trusts, and is sacrificial. And what I said to, you know, give an example of this is Jesus Christ. Jesus Christ died on the cross at Calvary. He shed blood for us. He forgave us for our sins. Our sins was paid for. You feel me? A lot of us, we are ashamed. We're holding on to things. We're guilty. But God, there's no condemnation in Christ Jesus. He forgave us. He died for us. This is the same type of love you want to give to the people that you say you love. When you love somebody, you protect them. You're not being the person that's abusing them mentally, physically, spiritually, emotionally. You're protecting them from things and people like that. You feel me? It's safe. Love is safe. Also, love, trust. So stop being so insecure. This world has brought up so many insecurities in relationships. And the best way the enemy can get in between God and like our divine purpose is through relationships. A lot of people, they don't even trust their spouse because the world is the way it is. It's so much promiscuity running around and stuff like that. Like, people don't trust their spouse because they're insecure. Let go of insecurity and them trust issues and trust your wife. Trust your husband. Trust them fully. Just give them that trust. Just be like, babe, I believe you. I know you are where you say you are. I believe you. I trust you. Until they show you, you can't trust them. You feel me? A lot of people, they holding on to their past baggage and bringing it into a new relationship that God may have blessed you with. And now because of your insecurities, you done ruined this new person and this new relationship that was supposed to be a blessing to you. All because you want to be insecure. Stop being insecure. Just trust. And also, a person should be able to trust too. You shouldn't be wearing a mask with people. You should be really trustworthy and just being a good person all across the board. And also, it's sacrificial. Like I said, Christ put his life on the line for us. You should be ready to put your life on the line for the person you say you love and protect them. You feel me? Love is safe. Also, the 10th and final biblical trait of love from the book of 1 Corinthians 13:4, it says, love rejoices in truth, not evil. Some examples of this is righteousness. God calls us to be righteous, and love is right. You feel me? And it rejoices in things that are true, that are honest, that are pure. That's why when you're with somebody that's not for you, you don't feel right. But when they love you, when everything is good, and I'm not talking about in a sinful, lustful type of way, I'm talking about when they really loving you like this, you're gonna feel good. You're gonna be happy. You're gonna have a glow. You feel me? And you want to be responsible for loving people like this too, so you can be somebody else's blessing and somebody else's reason to glow as well. Also, some other examples of this is it's genuine. The love is pure, it's genuine. You don't got no ill intentions with these people. They ain't got none with you. Like, love is a gift from God. It's a blessing. His greatest commandment is for us to love each other like we love ourselves and love each other like Christ loves us. God cares about love so much, and you should too. A lot of people, they jaded. They don't want no love. They don't want a relationship. Forgive. Let it go. God has some good love in store for you. You just got to get it. Also, this type of love that rejoices in truth and not evil is wholesome. So, yeah, this type of love is real. It's real. So, look, if you want to study this on your own, it's in the book of 1 Corinthians 13:4. It talks about what the biblical definition of love is. I want to remind you that the biblical definition of love is the successful definition of love. God already designed it out how he wants it to be done. So follow these things, and I'm telling you, you're going to be on the right path. And try to find somebody else who is following this type of definition of love, because this is the right definition. So many definition and girls out here telling y'all what love is, but this is what God says love is. So follow this outline for love, and remember that this is what love is when you are being the lover and when you're being loved. And just know that God put this in place for divine order. He wants things done in divine order. So I hope this video blessed you. Make sure you share it with someone who may be struggling or who wants to know what love is or who needs to know what love is. And I love you. God bless you. And I'll see you next time.